Today's after-school special deals with the subject of child molestation. Due to the sensitive nature of this topic, parents are encouraged to watch and discuss with their children. An innocent little girl.
Thank you for the nice present.
You're my very special birthday girl.
Whose life would never be the same.
This is our secret.
Only one person knew the truth.
I don't like the way Dom plays.
Only one person could help.
You'll never be alone with him again. I promise you.
And now, don't touch.
Birthday girl. Happy, happy, happy birthday. Come here. Hi.
Hello.
How's my special girl in her special day?
I'm good, yeah.
Keep her busy.
Yeah?
Mm-hmm. Hey, Molly. Come over here. Do you know what day this is today? I want to know if you look another year older yet. Hmm?
What do you think, Dad? Is it time? Do you think it's birthday present time?
Not yet.
Wait, you have to wait.
No,
this is a big moment. All right, 1, 2, 3.
Whoa! Hi, is it
mine? Yes, of course it's yours. Daddy made it for you.
It's really something, isn't it? Your mom did the decorating. I want you to look in this room right here. Look at this. See that paper? It's just like in your room.
Yeah. And Mike painted the whole outside for you.
Yeah, but your mom and dad did everything else.
Look, Molly, it's amazing. Look at the little kitchen stuff. There's a clock on the wall. I love it. I just love it. Can we play with it now?
Oh, sure.
Come on, Molly. I've got a surprise for you, too.
You do?
Of course I do. Let's see if you can find it.
Bye, Molly.
Bye.
Bye. Have a nice birthday dinner. Oh, bye. Thanks for being here.
Oh, take care, Karen.
See you later.
Something bugging Karen? She's acting very funny with Mike.
Oh, maybe she's got a crush on him.
That's a funny way to show it.
That's because you don't understand women very well. Well, not to worry. She'll get over it.
Well, at least she's got good taste.
Well, too bad she's too young for him.
Look at the hair. Is it real?
Yeah, it's real.
This one looks like me. Don't you think it looks like me?
Yeah, that's why I picked it out. See, a doll for a doll.
Thank you.
Now a hug.
Thank you for the nice present.
And don't I get a special kiss for such a special present? You are my best girl, you know. You're my very special birthday girl.
And then there's this traffic jam. I mean, Karen, you would not believe the scene. Gleason, Paul, and me. We get there at 2 in the morning, right? There are already hundreds of people standing in line. And one guy has got this lounge chair, his little TV, his cooler, all his stuff, right? He's been there for 2 nights. He wanted to be able to say he was the first guy in line. So we're standing there for 4 hours. And it starts to rain, and we're getting soaking wet. And this guy comes along the line selling big green garbage bags for umbrellas for $5 each.
Not for the box, you understand, for each garbage bag. Can you believe it?
What's the matter?
Something wrong?
No, I know. People who talk with their mouths will gross me out, too.
No, it's nothing. I'm just in a weird mood today.
Why, what happened?
Nothing happened.
Karen, you always tell me every little thing that bothers you.
I do.
For example, when you were 11 and they brought Teddy home from the hospital, you told me you thought he looked ugly.
He was.
Right, but did you tell anyone but me?
Of course not.
When you were 8, you told me you broke your mother's pearl necklace, but put it back without telling her.
The string was weak.
Right, but I'm the only one you told. And when you were 6, your goldfish died because you overfed it, even though your father had warned you to feed it only a few sprinkles of fish food a day. Am I right?
You're right.
And I'm the only one you confess this to, true or false?
True.
And do you remember what you said to me the day I moved next door? You said you didn't want any boys in the house.
I was 4 years old. How am I supposed to remember something I said when I was 4?
I remember. You also told me you were a special girl. You were right. You are.
Starts in 20 minutes.
All right, I'll hurry up. I love my dollhouse. Can we play with it every day?
Sure. Who's that?
I don't know.
It's Mike. What's he doing here?
Is today Monday?
Yeah.
He always comes to dinner on Monday.
At 4:30?
Hi.
Hi, Stuart won't be home for about another hour.
Yeah, I know. It's my day off, so I thought I'd come early and Molly and I could make some cookies for dessert. Surprise everybody.
See, I told you he was coming to dinner.
You can go on home if you like. Molly and I have got important work to do, don't we?
I just better call the store.
Sure. See what you think of these new chocolate chips. Go ahead. Try one.
Stewart's Hardware and Decorating.
Mrs. Stewart?
Yes?
Hi, it's Karen calling.
Oh, hi.
Listen, Mike just came over, and he said that he'd stay with Molly and that I should leave. But I just wanted to ask you about it.
Oh, it's all right. I mean, Mike's almost one of the family.
Right.
So you can just run along. Of course, you'll still be paid.
Karen, thank you for checking with me. And any time that Mike wants to take care of Molly, it's all right with us.
Well, okay. Bye-bye.
Bye, dear.
So, I'll be going then.
Oh, bye, Karen.
Bye.
I'll see you some cookies.
Bye-bye.
Bye-bye. You see, I brought all the ingredients, sugar.
Sugar. What else did you bring?
Oh, silly. You're my sugar. And I bought some real sugar, too. I'm so glad to see my special girl. How about a big kiss for Mike?
Nice, quiet child.
Mom!
I'm warning you. I'm counting to 10. 1, 2. I thought you were going to the movies tonight with David and everybody.
I just didn't feel like going out tonight.
You used to beg to stay out late. Now that you can, you stay home. Is everything okay with you?
Yeah, sure.
9. 10. Here I come.
I told you not to do that. I didn't do it.
I told you, no soccer balls in the house. Now put that thing away. George, put that. Anybody see my briefcase? Hold it! New rule. Now listen to me very carefully. From now on, if either of you spills anything, you both clean it up. Start.
Did not! Mom?
Good morning, honey.
How old was I when Uncle Walter lived with us?
Let's see. You were in kindergarten when he died. And lived with us a year before that. So I guess you were four. Hmm. He was a wonderful man. He loved you very much. I never had to worry about hiring babysitters that year. Your uncle would do anything for you. You were his special girl.
Yes. I remember.
Sorry, I didn't mean to scare you.
What are you doing here?
It's my day off. It's Monday. I was bored, so I told Ralph and Joan I'd hang out with Molly until supper. How's my girl?
I was gonna play dollhouse with Karen today.
That's right, I promised.
Oh, don't worry. I already told him I'd take care of her. Besides, I got this great present for the dollhouse at my place.
Another surprise?
You need a lift?
No, thanks.
That's one of the cars, a rotten pickle.
Molly, you'll see what he got for the dollhouse.
On your mark. Get set. Go.
See you tomorrow.
You won. Oh, it's great to see you. All right. You look real pretty today. Girl, actually, you look real pretty every day.
Thank you. Oh, neat.
I'll give you one clue about your present. It's smaller than a bread box and bigger than a roll. You got 20 questions. Start guessing.
Bigger than a roll? That's so big for my dollhouse.
Is that a question?
I thought you were coming over to Gleason's after babysitting.
Oh, well, I had some things to do for my mother.
So, what team are you going to be on, huh?
I'm not playing, thanks.
Oh, come on.
Hey, what's going on?
So, how's it going? Can, Paul get the station wagon for the concert on Wednesday?
Karen, something's bothering you. What is it?
It's about Molly. You know that guy, Mike, the guy who works at their store?
Yeah.
He's always hanging around her. It just gives me the creeps. Like today, you know what happened? He's bored on his day off, so he comes over to play with a six-year-old. Well, he doesn't even play at her house. He makes up some excuse to take her to his apartment.
You think he's messing with her?
Yes.
That's a pretty heavy accusation. Do you have any evidence?
Not really. It's just little things. The tone of his voice. The look in his eye. It's like she's his girlfriend, not a kid. I mean, that's the way it seems to me.
What does her mother think?
She thinks everything's fine.
Well, maybe it is.
Maybe.
So, am I gonna see you tonight? What about it?
It's all you ever think about.
Come on, that's crazy.
Will you just leave me alone?
Is that what you want, Karen? You got it.
If I guess it, will you tell me where it is?
Well, I think you're gonna find it before you guess it. See the other great thing I found at the toy store this morning.
What? Paint?
Oh, well, special paint. Now, close your eyes and put out your arm. Sure, that's why they call it body paint. Okay. Guess what I drew?
It's a flower. Can I try?
Well, let me have another try first. That was just practice. But I need more room. It's so little. Hey, I know. Your back. I could do something fantastic there. A masterpiece. Yeah, just turn around and pull up your shirt. It's such a great idea. Well, come on, then you can do something on my back.
Okay.
This is gonna be beautiful.
Today, sweetie, why don't you go play with your friends? I can handle supper.
No, that's okay. I didn't have to take care of Molly today after all.
No, how come?
Well, you know that guy Mike? He works in the store.
Mm-hmm.
Well, he came by to take her to his place to play. Mrs. Stewart said that anytime he wants to do that, to let him. He's like really close to their family.
It's nice, like an extended family. It's good to see people helping each other out like that, like your Uncle Walter helping take care of you. Too bad he isn't here to help with Teddy and George. It might work better if you take him out of the bag first.
Well, what do you think? Isn't it great being silly? Now, the artist needs to do a little touch-up on Teddy. So turn him around. Uh-oh! I got paint on your shirt. Well, you better take it off so I can wash it.
No, it's okay. My mom will wash it.
No, it's not. See, this is our secret, remember? Now, off with the shirt. Now, three people came into the store this week looking for a pasta-making machine.
I want to go to that trade show in New York. I want to see the whole line of housewares.
Well, maybe we should start a whole new department for that stuff. We could use a painting room and move the mixing to the cellar. What do you think?
Well, that was my idea a year ago. I'm going to go check on Molly, see if she's finally dropped off.
No, I'll go.
Oh, no, don't be silly. You've done enough for Molly today.
You know, if you think you should go to the show, go. I can take care of the store for a day or two.
Still awake? It's nearly 10 o'clock. Aren't you tired?
When's Mike going home?
Oh, I don't know. A little while, I guess. Do you want him to come upstairs and say goodnight? He could do his Eddie Teddy invitation for you.
I don't like it when he acts silly.
Well, you're silly. Loves yourself, do you know? Good night.
Oh, can I sleep with it on?
Yeah, of course you can. Good night.
Okay. Good night.
Sweet dreams.
Sweet dreams.
Is she asleep?
No.
No.
Oh. She says she doesn't like it when you're silly. Well, maybe you better learn some new imitations.
Hey, boo-boo.
Oh. Now, listen to this, honey. No, Mike's offered to take care of Molly and the store so we can go to the trade show. We can leave Saturday afternoon. He'll sleep over Saturday night, Sunday night. Monday's the lightest day at the store anyway. It's perfect.
And it's no trouble to me.
Oh, Molly's been having so much trouble sleeping lately, huh?
Oh, you guys just don't know how to tell a good bedtime story. Oh, she'll be fine with me.
Been dreaming.
Karen, what happened?
I was just playing a little trick on David, Mom. I'm sorry if I scared you.
Oh, well, I don't know about you, but she sure scared the daylights out of me.
I'm sorry, Mom.
As long as you're all right.
Why'd you lie?
I don't know.
What were you dreaming about? I've never seen you so scared.
Nothing.
Was I in it?
Oh, no, David. The dream was about my uncle. Do you remember him? He lived with us when I was little.
The one that was in the car crash?
Yeah, and that's why I didn't want to tell my mom, because it would just upset her.
So the dream was about the accident?
Not really.
What was it about then?
Look, it was nothing.
We have never had any secrets from each other. There is nothing you could tell me that would change the way I feel about you.
I can't tell you. It's too embarrassing.
You're shutting me out again.
He molested me, okay? At night, when everyone was sleeping, or when he babysat for me. During that whole year he lived with us, he was doing it. That's what the nightmare was about.
Did you tell your mother?
He told me that if I ever told anyone, something terrible would happen to my parents. They died. That's what's so strange is, ever since I've been learning about Molly, I've been having these nightmares. I didn't remember any of it until now.
That's awful. You were just a little girl.
Fever or anything. I don't know what's been wrong with her lately. She hasn't been acting like herself. Anyway, I'll be back in about an hour.
I shouldn't give her any medicine or anything?
No, just some more juice, maybe. Oh, by the way, assuming that Molly's all right, Ralph and I might go on a little business trip this weekend. We'll leave tomorrow after we close the store.
Come on, Karen. Everyone's waiting for you.
Everyone?
Her dolls.
Oh.
Just tell them to hold their horses. I'll be up in a minute.
They don't have any horses.
I'll be right there.
Bye.
Anyway, our being away doesn't really affect you. Mike is going to come and stay and look after Molly on the weekend. You can meet the day camp bus as usual on Monday. We should be back, Monday evening around supper time.
Well, why don't I take care of her on the weekend, too? I'd really like to.
Oh, that's really sweet of you, but we've already made arrangements.
Well, you wouldn't have to pay me or anything. I'd really like to.
No, it's not about the money. Well, we just rest easier if there was an adult in the house overnight. I mean, you can understand that, can't you?
I'd like to go for a walk or something. Talk some more about, you know.
Look, I'm trying to forget that.
Forget it?
Yeah. I did it before. I can do it again. So just don't mention it again, okay?
If you say so. Anyway, Paul will be by to pick us up at 7. Oh, and I brought these for the concert tonight. I looked at our tickets, and our seats are practically in Alaska.
I'm not going to the concert.
Look, the tickets aren't that bad. You mean that you're not going? Why? It's because you're upset about your uncle.
I just don't want to go, so don't bug me about it, okay?
What are you doing to us here? We planned this for months. If you're trying to break up with me, Karen, you better tell me why.
I don't want to go, period.
Well, I just don't like being treated this way, period.
Well, fine, then leave me alone.
Okay, well, I will.
Right.
You're a terrific friend, Karen Anderson. Full of surprise.
Thanks for taking me, Dave. I had a really good time.
Hiya.
Hi. Is he okay?
Sorry.
It's only water.
I'm sorry.
I was really terrible to you.
I wasn't exactly Mr. Understanding. I know you're going through a lot worrying about Molly and all that stuff with your uncle. Anyway, I'm just sorry you missed the concert.
Me too.
Friends?
Friends. I need help. This business with Molly is getting really complicated.
Why? What's happened?
Her parents are leaving her alone with Mike for the weekend.
Mm-hmm.
He's sleeping at their place while they're away.
What are you going to do?
What can I do? I still don't have anything concrete to go on.
Why don't you talk to Molly? Get her to tell you what's been going on.
A little kid wouldn't tell you something like that.
I read this article in the paper the other day. They gave examples, you know, from actual cases. They use puppets and stuff, and the kids open up, especially with someone they trust. I saved it for you. You want to see it?
Sure. Of course I do. Your mom told me that, she's going away for the weekend to New York, and that Mike's staying with you?
Uh-huh.
Do you like that?
Well, maybe I'll get sick again and they won't go.
Even if they don't go this time, they'll go sometime. Anyway, you seem pretty healthy to me. And they're going this afternoon. Don't you like Mike?
He's okay. Let's watch TV.
Now, let's play Dollhouse.
Okay, if you really want to.
Can I be the mother today?
Okay.
Max and Tim are in the living room watching TV. The mother is in the kitchen with Lissy. You be Lissy.
What about Max and Tim?
You be Max and I'll be Tim. Okay, guys. It's time for your Little League game. You better move it.
I'm gonna get you.
Hey, stop hitting. Let's go.
Okay, Mom. Gotta go. See you later.
Bye, Pipsqueak. You took my glove.
I did not. What do you want to do now, Mommy? Want to make some cookies?
I forgot to tell you. I have to go to a meeting. My friend Don is gonna come over and take care of you.
Oh.
You like my friend Don, don't you?
Well, yeah, I guess so. But I don't like it when he acts silly.
Ring-a-ling-a-ling. There's Don now. Right on time. Hello, Don. Glad to see you.
Hi, Linda. Hi, Lissy. How's my special girl?
Okay.
Bye, Don. Bye, Lissy. Now, you be a good girl and you do what Don says.
Bye, Mommy.
Let's play up in your room. I love it up there. It's so pretty.
Okay, but I'd rather watch TV.
Come on, I'll race you up the stairs. I won.
This is such a comfortable bed. I'm tired. I think I'll lie down. I have a headache. Will you rub my head?
Okay.
I bet you're tired, too.
No.
I bet you are.
Tickle, tickle, tickle.
Stop! 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 Karen, I don't want to play anymore.
Just a little bit longer.
I don't like the way Don plays.
I have an idea. You be Don, and that way you can show me everything he does that Lissy doesn't like. Don't tickle. I can't stand it.
Okay, then. Lie down and I'll give you a massage like we did at my house.
And you won't tickle anymore?
No. Lie on your back and I'll rub you all over.
Never be alone with him again. I promise you.
And I'll help you tell your mother. She'll make sure of it.
No, no, don't tell Mommy. Mike said if I tell, she'll send me away.
No. She'll be upset because he tricked you and he hurt you. But I promise you, your mother would never send you away. That's just another one of his awful lies.
They're here.
You want me to go first?
Oh, hi.
Can I talk to you?
Sure.
Hold on.
Is everything all right?
Where's Molly?
Oh, she's fine. She's upstairs taking a nap. I need your advice. It's personal.
Well, of course. Let's go upstairs to my room. We can talk while I pack for the trip.
I want you to look at these catalogs.
I'll be down in a minute.
Probably some kind of boy trouble.
She should ask Molly how to handle a guy. She got me wrapped around her little finger. Oh, this is good.
This?
But you're still...
Yeah, but I like this one better.
He touched me all over. He wouldn't stop doing it. I didn't like it.
Oh, my baby. I'll take care of everything. It's gonna be all right. It will. Daddy and I'll take care of you. It was terrible of Mike to trick you like that. It's not your fault. Do you understand that? I'm very angry with him. And he's not going to be near you again.
Will you put him in jail?
It's not just up to me. But I do know he's not going to be in our lives anymore, and he's not going to bother you or any other kid again. Oh, sweet girl.
Hey, let's get this show on the road.
Maybe Molly should come to my house for a few hours, and that way you can tell your husband.
Yeah, call the authorities.
Where's my girl?
Molly?
Is everything okay?
Everything's gonna be just fine. Mom's going to be taking her to a therapist.
What about you? You still think you can block out all that stuff about your uncle?
No. Not anymore.
So what are you going to do?
I'm going to tell my mother what her brother did to me. I need her help. She's going to be so upset. I wish I didn't have to.
Your mother would die for you, Karen, am I right? I think she can handle this. I mean, the Molly thing upset you. Look how well you handled it. You didn't run away from it. You figured out a way to get her to talk to you. I mean, that dollhouse thing was brilliant.
Well, I had a little help. My best friend.
Down.
someone who's hurting a child, or if you're a child who needs help, call toll-free 1-800-4-A-CHILD.
ABC After School Specials, brought to you by Kellogg's Mini Wheat Cereal. Wholesome shredded wheat for the adult in you, plus great taste for the kid in you. So they're nutritious and delicious.
Friday, it's lights, cameras, and lots of action when Webster's off to visit his Uncle Philip in Hollywood. Then Vereen guest stars on Webster. Then Bob Uecker renews his wedding vows and uncovers some very startling facts on Mr. Belvedere. Sunday, MacGyver treks to the jungles of South America to fight nature's deadliest phenomenon on MacGyver.